bounties.
Weeping Angel. This has got to be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon? Maybe in one of these.
Got it.
Now I just gotta figure out who I'm gonna give this to.
Boozer! Boozman, are you listening? Oh, you're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me and acted like I wasn't even there!
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing!
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. And don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid!
God. Finally. There we go.
Whoa, hold on, they're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
Researcher, what the hell are they doing out here? Gotta go check them out, see what they're doing. All right, gotta go in quiet.
I heard something.
Stop! Yeah, you are entering a quarantine area!
Researcher, what the hell are they doing out here? see what you're doing. All right, I'm sure they're quiet.
Okay. Field note 2000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey, Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. That us?
No, it's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson. Your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Did you hear me? Over 400 subjects. And these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
Then what the hell?
They're sleeping like babies.
No, 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 forget it.
And I asked if you were going in. Didn't say I was.
Okay, stay well, stay well.
These subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White King Mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like he was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. But not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was FUBAR from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
Think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
Secret caves. Yeah, right. Like anyone gives a damn.
Doesn't matter. You flew over farewell? That was a lot of goddamn freakers.
Yeah. A few dozen at least.
Hope we got enough fuel to get back. Going all over hell and back today.
But fuel's the least of our problems when we're all around. Stay focused.
I really hate these assignments.
Yeah, I hear you. Let me guess. You'd rather be in the Meltdown games than eating the Breaker shit?
Wasn't even my turn on the duty roster.
Blame the CO. I look like the CO.
How long this will take?
Too damn long.
That's how long. Yeah. Hey, you heard that? That's right, go check it out.
How much longer do you think we got?
How the hell do I know? Oh, out with the doctor.
Bushes. I gotta keep to the bushes.
Time now.
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
When we rode out of Farewell, the Nero guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
Wait, what are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. You wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait. You went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
I'm not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... get some sleep. Deacon out.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The start of this living hell that is now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was one of the few. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know, because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. Broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the Rose King choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
No.
Infestation zone later.
Won't be needing this.
Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free.
Black helicopters have been spotted in the skies.
Hey, Cope, this man I'm tracking down. Who do you kill?
Why do you care? It's just another bounty job, isn't it?
Now look, I don't care. I just want to know their names. Who, Cope?
One of them is a man named Randall. Been with the camp almost a year. I didn't know the other two. You want me to ask?
No. Guess not.
You find that son of a bitch, you radio me. Copeland out.
And they're proof that I was right.
We thought Nero died out here like the rest of them. Caving under their own stupidity. But no. Like I said, they've been lying and wait all this time till they can crawl up out of their holes and reclaim this world. But it ain't happening. Not on my watch. And don't go running towards them, thinking they're gonna save your ass. Any man wearing a uniform worth a damn died more than 2 years ago. These men, they'll shoot you on sight. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Jesus. Cope, they're not trying to reclaim shit. You don't have a damn clue what you're talking about. Except, yeah, they will shoot you on sight. Lucky guy. More scrap. Fuel can. Gotcha.
Mike.
There he is! Silver helmet. Red gas tank. That's it.
Oh, shit! The hell?
So you thought you'd ride into Copeland's camp, shoot the place up, that about right? Kill a few folks, take some shit, and just ride out like you were just chopping.
Let him get away, Deke.
Screw you, Drifter! You working for Copeland? Yeah?
Not a fan of him myself, if you want to know the truth. Give Drifters a bad name. What if you'd shot Manny? You know, who'd fix my bike then? Stupid piece of shit.
Screw you! You want to cope with Stoney's? You little bitch! That's what you are! You little bitch!
Nope, it's done. Got him.
You tell.
Mark down these coordinates and send your man out here.
Is he alive?
Hey, Drifter.
Yeah, he's alive. But I won't promise you how long he's gonna stay that way. Deacon out.
You tell him, Drifter. You tell him I said go. He goes to himself.
Boozer, you there? I was just calling a checkup on you.
Yeah, Dean, come here.
Hang in there, buddy. As soon as we get that arm patched up, we're riding north, just like you said.
I hope so. We got it, so
we're just working on getting better. I still got some work to do on the bike, and we gotta stock up on some gear. Once you're patched up, we're out of here. Deacon out. That's right, I gotta burn out the rest of these nests.
Murderers and thieves, the lot of you. How many people you killed today, huh? Crap, someone's trapped. I gotta help.
Yeah. Hey. It's okay. Hey, it's not safe out here in the shit. I know where there's a camp that...
What camp? It's a camp? Where? Show me. I'll go.
Peaceful Lake. Mark Copeland. It's safe there.
Oh, man. Thank you. I was done for. Holy shit! I was a goner, you know? Whew! Thank you so much, man. Thank you.
Tell him it was Deacon. They'll know. Don't stop. Just keep out of sight.
No, sniper. Let's ambush her, yeah?
They've been shot!
Yeah, meat.
One of the biker boys. Open the gate.
Where's Tucker? Alki.
Over at the dig site.
Well, which one, goddammit?
The north one. Back there.
Anybody touches this bike, or anything on it, I break your fingers.
Whatever, man. Jesus.
I'm telling you, everywhere you look, it's all one giant lava field. 25 feet solid rock. It'll take jackhammers to...
I don't need a lecture, goddammit. I get it.
No, you don't. But these people are hungry. Even if they had all their strength, it'll take them months to finish this job with picks and shovels.
I don't give a shit! We're all hungry, Al. But this job's gotta get done, whether it takes all goddamn year. It's not like we got somewhere else to be now, do we?
Wait. Not finished.
We'll make it quick, will ya, Al? I got things to do.
Rippers. This morning, one of my men spotted a large group of them coming over the pass.
And no one stopped them?
How the f... Tucker, you know we're already spread thin.
Are they headed north? Al! Are they headed towards us? Yes or no?
I don't know. Maybe he knows.
What the fuck are you up to now, huh? What's this about, huh?
Damn it, Alkai. It's not his job to know. It's your goddamn job to know.
I can't be at two places at one time. You either want me here, running your dig, or you want me out there in the shit, chasing the Rippers.
Go check the store, see how much ammo we got left. I'll tell Wheeler to watch the dig.
What are you looking at?
Oh, I don't know, just waiting for you to smarten the fuck up.
Don't! Did you track down Leon? Good thing someone around here knows how to make things happen. Ride with me. How long's it been since you found someone, brought him in?
The kind of people left out in the shit aren't the kind of people you want me bringing in.
We lost two more to the fever.
It's not my problem.
You want our food? I'm making it your problem.
I told you, we'll do runs for you, but we're not joining your goddamn camp.
Remind me again, my old woman's memory. Why is that?
Because it's a waste of time, Tuck.
Well, aren't you the optimist? Where's Boozer?
He said he was gonna head over to Copeland's camp, see about trading for some fish.
You're not in bed with Cope now, are you? His camp near yours?
It's not closer or further. Look, I'm not Boozer's old lady. He goes where he wants. Jesus.
Can't breathe.
You keep the shit burning all day and night.
Got a lot of freak corpses piling up out here. With men like you doing your jobs. Damn right we keep burning.
Try using more gasoline. Burns faster, less fumes.
Like we got so much to spare? When it's all gone, what are you gonna put in that bike of yours? Spit and sweat? Now what the hell is going on here?
The count's off. Storage is missing food and some ammo.
Jesus. Who was on watch last night?
Wheeler.
Tonight, double the watch. This shit's starting to piss me off.
You got it.
Trouble in paradise.
It's like I was saying. Camp's like a prison. Bunch of goddamn lazy liars, thieves, rapists, and murderers. You know why that is?
No idea.
Because that's who we are. The freak show. Only folks survived were those mean enough, nasty enough to out-freak the freaks. The rest are here, hoping I feed them, protect them, keep them nice and cozy and warm, so they can sit on their asses and watch the world end. You! Get your ass back to work! Don't make me go get Cyrus! Lazy sons of bitches can screw around all they like on their time. Daytime is my time. Running this camp is no different than running a prison.
I can't remember what you said. You were what? You were a warden or something?
Nothing so high and mighty. I was matron of the women's ward. You look like the sort who might have spent some time in the pen back in the day. You ever do time?
I had my share of trouble, but I never landed in K-State.
I got a job for you. Larson was on a run yesterday. Passed through Marion Fork, said he saw someone. Young woman, looked like. But he only caught a glance. He stopped to look around, but he never found her.
Is he sure?
Larson's been doing this long as you. He knows a person from a freak. But you got a knack for this. You head over there and find her before the freaks do.
I'll see what I can do. But look, Tuck, I want the rest of my credits for Leon.
You bring me warm bodies, I'll give you all the credits you can spend. I gotta go find Wheeler. Someone's looking at a night in the shack.
Can I help you? I'm gonna stretch my legs for a while.
Alkai. What do you want, Drifter?
What's your problem?
One of my men escaped to Ripper Camp over by Iron Butte. Got tortured, like they always do. But this time they kept asking me if you knew about it. Two bikers, two men. Ask him if you'd ever seen him or heard of him.
A lot of bikes around here. What's it got to do with me?
The Ripper called them mongrels.
How many drifters still flying colors around here? As if that shit matters. If you ask me, you got a price on your head. How's it feel to be on the other side?
Now, why don't you just show me what you got, because I don't have time for your bullshit.
Whatever you say, Deke.
What do you need?
Thanks. Can I get anything else for you? Okay, sure.
I just gotta figure out who I'm gonna give this
to. Get to it. Stop screwing around. Hey, back to work.
We can't head north until I get this bike fixed up.
Hey,
Copeland,
no, don't. Getting the work. All right. Stop it.
Yeah? I'm gonna look around.
Just get to work. You'll be okay.
Can I help you?
Hey, Doc. So, am I on your trust list or no?
Can I help you?
Hey, what's going on?
There you go. Let me have a look at it. Okay. See ya.